Well, I was going to Rat Brown is the chairman of the SNCC organization.
Yeah! I come back a few years later and I still find race speaks about that, dividing the community. Now that ain't bad, you see, because we want to be by ourselves anyway. We don't want to be with no animals. Monkeys are animals. The cracker is an animal. We don't need to be with him. One thing we want to do, we gonna control our community, see? We ain't gonna have the honky coming over here and appointing five or six nigger cops to come down here and ruin our community. We gonna control our community. That's what we gonna do. That's black power. That's what you talk about when you talk about black power. Newark exploded. Newark exploded. See, Harlem exploded. Dayton exploded. Cincinnati exploded. It's time for Cambridge to explode, baby. We've been they say if Dayton don't come round, we gonna burn Dayton down. Black folks built America. If America don't come round, we should burn it down, brother. We gonna get our share of it. Take your violence to the honky. Take it to the crack. The street belongs to us. We got to take them. They ain't gonna get it to us. We got to take them. Ain't no reason in the world. But on the other side of Ray Street, the funky Peckerwood cracker owns all the stores, and we take all the money. Hell,
don't you know that?
Hell, don't you know they outnumber us? Always they outnumber us. Hey, David was outnumbered when he called for life. He was outnumbered. Daniel in the lion den was outnumbered. Moses was outnumbered. All of us outnumbered. That don't make no difference. But let me tell you, brother, we work in their houses. They ain't got to leave home. They ain't got to leave home. When they want to do a walk and they let us come in their house, that show you how stupid the honky is. Because he ain't got to leave home. This way, brothers who in Vietnam comprised 22% of that fighting force, and we 10% over here. You got to look at they killing you off. And they killing off all the black young men. So ladies, you better get ready. Because you got to fight for two. You ain't got no business letting your brother and your sons, your nephews, go to that war. That ain't your war. Right. But you better get you some guns. You better get you some guns. The man is moving to kill you. And the only thing that honky respects is force. He proved this up there in Plainfield, New Jersey. And let me tell you what he did in Newark. He killed 24 people. That's too many people to lose. We ain't got no business losing 24 people. But in Plainfield, which is about 12 miles from Newark, the brothers broke in some stores and stole themselves some guns. They stole them some guns. They stole 46 guns. They ain't stealing. How can you steal from a thief? He done stole everything from us. So don't you worry about that. But look at the brothers did in Plainfield. The brothers got their stuff. They got 46 automatic weapons. 46 automatic weapons. So the Peckerwood goes down there to take the weapons, and they stomp one of them to death. They stomp the cop to death. Do it, he did. Yeah. They stomp him to death. They stomp him. You know, y'all might think that's brutal, but it ain't no more brutal than killing a pregnant woman. And that's what the honky does. He kills pregnant black women. They stomped him to death and threw a shopping basket on his head, took his pistol and shot him, and then cut it. And you know he was hurt. Yeah. Because they don't like to hear about niggas cutting. They don't want to know anything about niggas cutting. And they cut it. But then they went back to their community with their 46 weapons, and they told that trucker would pop, and the brother saw what was going on, and the brother told him, if you kick down one more door, I'm going to shoot your leg off. And look what the honky did. He left. That's the kind of force he respects. Brothers, you better get some guns. I don't care if it's a BB gun with poison BB. People and he don't mind killing them. It might be your son he kills next. Or it might be your daughter, or it might be you. So wherever you go, brother, take some of them with you. That's what you do, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, tip for tap, brother. That's the only kind of world that man knows. That's the only thing he recognizes. Ain't no need in the world for me to come to Cambridge and I see all them stores sitting up there with all them hunkies over there owning them. You got to own some of them stores. I don't care if you have to burn them down and run them out. You better take over them stores. The streets of yours. Take them. They gave you the streets a long time ago before they gave you houses. They gave you the streets. So we own the streets. Take them. You see that school over there? I don't know if the hunky went to that school or not, but y'all should have burnt that school a long time ago. You should have burned it down to the ground, brother. You're going to have to start studying your history. You got to understand that black folks is not a minority. We ain't got more black folks across the world than they got white people. Right. You got to start looking at China like brothers because they are yellow people. Viet Cong, some of the Viet Congs are browner than some of us, nigga. All India, Indians are dark-skinned people. These are the colored people of the world. These are the black people of the world. That's the third world that they be talking about. All other people. Now, Hunky is surrounded. He's surrounded. He don't know what to do. But brother, believe me, he know what to do here because you let him do it. See, he done renovated 26 concentration camps across the world. You don't know what a concentration camp is, then he run it down. You heard about all them Jews that burned up by Hitler? Uh-huh. They burned them up. They take them to concentration camps. And then they took them from the concentration camp to the front. They told them they was going to get showers. And then they turned on the gas and killed them and took them out to a front and burned them. That's a concentration camp. Now, America done renovated 26, and it ain't from the Indians because they're on reservations. Now, thank who it's for. All right, now that you know who it's for. See, it's Charles Whitland in Texas who shot all them hunkies. That's violence. The white man don't never look at that. Vietnam is violence. As soon as you go out there and burn down a few old filthy stores that you own anyway, the band saying, well, you trying to be violent. Well, we can't try to be violent with him. He knows all about violence. He taught us how to be violent. But we've been using our violence in the wrong way. We've been using violence against each other. Ain't no need in the world for black people to have to fight each other. You ain't got no business in the world hitting your brother. I don't care if he make you mad. If my brother make me mad, I'm going to go look for a hump. I'm gonna take out 400 years worth of dues on him, too. Take out 400 years worth of dues, because that's the dues he owe you for knowing you and owing you. His dog gave you two arms, gave you two legs, just like he gave you everything the honky gave you, but the honky been using his. You ain't been using yours. He just been running around here letting them do anything they want. I mean, don't be trying to love that hockey to death. Shoot him to death. Shoot him to death, brother. Because that's what he's out to do to you. Do to him like he would do to you, but do it to him first. Like I said in the beginning, if this town don't come around, this town should be burnt down. It should be burnt down, brother. They're going to have to live in the same stuff I live in, because I ain't going to make it no better for them. But do this, brother. Don't burn up your own stuff. Not tear up your own stuff. Whenever you decide to fight the man, take it to his battleground. It's one thing that man expects. That's money. That's his goal. When you tear down his coat, you hit his religion. You can right well hate him on Sunday in his pocket. That's the only goal that man got in his pocket. That's his best friend in his pocket. So when you move to get him, don't tear up your stuff. Don't tear up your coat. Don't burn down that house.